Here we are on What's Happening, and we are Who If What on the Internet YouTube channel. We're going to interview two people, Kathy Smith from the League of Women Voters and Neil Jasek from Citizens for a Better New York, and we'll let you both give a little plug or whatever.
Thank you. The League of Women Voters is a nonpartisan organization. We're 91 years old. It's national, state, and local. We work on voter registration and education of voters on issues before they go to the polls at election time. We've been here in Rochester for 86 years, and I'm presently the president of the local group, the Rochester Metro Group.
Citizens for Better New York is a local organization that's about 7 years old. Got started by half a dozen folks that had written letters to the editor during the years the state legislature was going for a record of how many years in a row they could have a late budget. And these folks felt they had something in common to try to make New York state government work more effectively and formed the organization Citizens for a Better New York. We are also nonpartisan. We're also non-ideological. We have people that are very conservative. We have people that are very liberal. What unites us is the fact that we recognize the way New York state government is currently set up. It is dysfunctional, as the Brennan Center said several years ago, and does not even provide a process in which those of us with different viewpoints can engage one another and deal with these issues intelligently. So we focus on four major points: reform of the rules of the legislature, independent redistricting, campaign finance reform, and initiative and referendum. All process issues that would, if enacted, help New York government work more effectively. You can find out more about us on the web at www. Then the initials of our organization, CFBNY.org, O-R-G.
We're going to talk about election reform, and basically a lot of us that are on the know feel the elections are pretty much fixed, that the politicians get in there and they do what they want, and I think most people kind of know that, but because they don't have to worry about getting voted out, a lot of them do what they want. So whether you think, you know, getting jobs or lowering your taxes or whatever is more important, that I can tell you it's not going to happen until we get valid elections. We get politicians that are nervous that they do the right things. So anyways, we're going to talk first about redistricting or gerrymandering. Who wants to take this?
Well, you hit the nail on the head. Gerrymandering is one of the elements of our program that we talked about that allow the legislatures to basically ignore their constituents. They draw district boundary lines in such a way that they're guaranteed re-election. As a result, they have to pay more attention to their leaders than they do to their constituents. And so they are very easily, I don't want to say manipulated, but very easily influenced by the powers that be, rather than you and I, who are pulling the lever and sending them back to Albany. So without independent redistricting, as well as the other parts of our program, we're not going to get the kind of responsiveness that we need in order to clean government up.
So this is why basically they have the census, so they can redraw the districts to the, you know, the population moves or changes?
Well, the law requires that the districts be redrawn whenever there is a census, and there is a census every 10 years at the federal level. Actually, if New York State had enough money to conduct its own census, say at the five-year intervals, that would also open the gate to doing some redistricting at that time. But there has to be a census before you can redistrict. And the main purpose, or at least the objective purpose of it, is to draw those districts to make sure that we do have one person, one vote in each of the districts, and the districts do have equal population.
Who draws these lines?
Well, right now the legislators do.
Which one?
Which ones? They all of them. They in the past years, there's been sort of a gentleman's agreement between the Assembly and the Senate, where the members of the Assembly would influence the way the Assembly boundaries are drawn, and the members of the Senate would influence the way the Senate boundaries are drawn, and then somehow the two of them would reach some agreement on how they would draw the boundaries for the U.S. Congress.
Isn't there some agreements they've said, and I believe now, that like, we won't go after your guy if you don't go after our guy, like we're both guaranteed jobs, kind of like?
Well, yeah. I mean, that's the basis on which they're drawn. It's instead of being drawn to provide balance in terms of districts that actually represent a specific community of interest or a neighborhood, they warp them this way and that just to make sure that it protects the incumbent.
So you basically have a Democrat district, like isn't Louise Slaughter's district goes from Fairport to the city of Rochester,
right,
and then up along the coastline of Lake Ontario to,
right, and all the way to
Buffalo, and it's a very Democratic district. I mean, a Republican has a snowball's chance in Hades of winning, or
that's correct. And similarly, well, with the Congress, they sort of reach a balance. Because both the Assembly Democrats and the Senate Republicans, that is the State Assembly and State Senate Republicans, realize their objective really is to protect the balance on the congressional delegation. So they'll allow so many Democratic seats and so many Republican seats. And it's going to be very interesting this year since New York is losing two congressional seats. But I think the consensus will be that they'll try to make one of those losses a Democratic loss and one of those a Republican loss, and God knows how they're going to come up with that.
Isn't it true the Republicans are nervous in the Senate because they, if they lose the Senate, they're going to get redistrict out, you know, bad districts, and if they let it go to this independent commission, there's not enough Republicans in the state, they're not going to get a good district they can win anyway, so they're really in a bad place?
Well, the New York State Senate has already passed their bill on redistricting last Tuesday. And,
oh, yeah.
And their bill is to have a constitutional amendment to the New York State Constitution.
So I remember this. Yeah, Mr. Skelos talked about that. He says it wasn't constitutional or something, just to pass the independent redistricting or something like that.
Well, it's a two-year process to get an amendment to the New York State Constitution. So it would have to pass both houses, and there is not talk of doing it with an amendment in the Assembly. But if that did happen, then you still would have to have it passed in the next session of the legislature before it would go on the ballot for the people.
Isn't that, according to some people, stalling tactics?
There are people who view it that way, yes.
Well, of course it is. I mean, the fact is that in order to affect this year's or this decade's redistricting, which will take place in 2012, we have to have legislation on the books this year. So by taking this stonewalled route of going through the constitutional amendment process, they guarantee that they'll gerrymander in 2012, because there's no way they can get a constitutional amendment done in time to affect this next redistricting.
At the local level, it has to be done now. By the local level, I mean municipalities in Monroe County. So it would be the Monroe County Legislature, the City of Rochester, and then also the Town of Greece. They have four election districts in the Town of Greece. It's such a large town. So you look at two things. The League of Women Voters, we look at who gets appointed to the commission that does the drawing of the lines. And we, and Neil's group also has really worked on that with the Monroe County Legislatures. They decided to have themselves do it. By that I mean the president of the legislature, the majority leader, the minority leader, and the two election commissioners. Then in the town of Greece, I believe it's, it might even be tomorrow night that they're looking at it in the town of Greece. In the past of the town of Greece, the elected officials have made the district lines. So what the League of Women Voters and other organizations ask for is that the criteria that they use for drawing the lines and the process, who's drawing the lines, and then what we really are looking at is once those lines are drawn on an initial map, that the public has a meeting where they can do some input. We're not convinced, the League is not convinced at the county level whether that's going to happen or not until after the lines are drawn. So we actually have asked the Center for Government Research, we have paid them to draw some lines. And what we want to do is compare their maps, which are based on the census material, which comes out this week, and the maps that are drawn by the county legislators' staff, and see what kinds of differences we can point out. We think people, when they can see their own neighborhoods and the difference in how the districts might be drawn using different criteria, that it might engage more people to realize the significance of this process. It's very important. It's only done every 10 years. I do not see any real changes in the way it's done this year. We're talking about another 10 years before we can have any influence on who draws the lines and the criteria they use for drawing the lines, the process.
That's a long wait.
You want to mention your forum on the 14th of April?
April 14th, we're actually going to have the League of Women Voters locally. We'll have a forum on the Monroe County lines, and the director of the Center for Government Research, Dr. Kent Gardner, Brighton Town Hall, 7 p.m. Dr. Kent Gardner will do the maps that his independent researchers have done using strictly census material. Those programs today can be done almost by the computer than with a professional staff looking at them. They can do the numbers of people, the census numbers, block by block. They call them census block data. That's how accurate they can be today.
Yeah.